Hey folks, Ruhani here. Welcome back. Here's a short story. I've been developing SaaS and products for nearly 3 decades. In my endless hunt for all-rounder AI development tool, I have realized most tools ships the first version very good, then struggle with the continuous feature improvements, deployments, testing, and feature changes. Today, I'll show Agent 3 by Replit running a weekly page speed check on 2 of my sites and emailing the report every Monday morning. Very practical, simple autonomy. Describe the goal and let it run on schedule. And that's not all. I also built a Telegram bot that uses OpenAI to mimic a personality for conversation. In this case, our Mr. Stark, the Iron Man himself. But first thing, go to replit.com/agent3. Get a free account. It takes less than 2 minutes. Once done, log into the backend where we will do all sort of cool stuff. You will also get the $10 credit if you use my referral link. Links are in the description. So here is the project setup. Go to Replit Home. After you log in, go to Agents and Automations. What you need to have on your hand is a PageSpeed API key from Google Cloud Console and the email address you want this report to be. So what we are going to do, we are going to send the goal to the agent with the prompt. Here is the prompt. I'm going to paste it right now. By default, it is set on the web app. So what we are going to do, we are going to go to Agents and Automations and click on time-based. And then we are going to paste the prompt here. It looks like this. Build a weekly automation for every Monday at 9 a.m. my time. Call Google PageSpeed Insights for robin.blog and genaitools.app. Fetch mobile and desktop strategies. Return Lighthouse performance score, LCP, CLS, INP if available. Compose a clean email summary with a short table and send it to this email address. You can define the email address here. At this point, you can start the chat. We can see the process have already started. We are going to take a look how it plans it and confirm the plan with you and then start building it. In this step, the agent is waiting for our. So what we are going to do, we are going to select build the entire app because this is a automation, not a full-scale app. So start with design is not available. So at this point, I'm going to click start building. And this is your automation testing and environment canvas. We can see all the things that is happening. At this point, it is asking for the Google Cloud Console PageSpeed Insights API key. So I'm just going to paste it. I have pasted the API key, so I'm going to click continue and let it do its work. It will need an email address where it can send the email. The agent has completed its task and it is ready to publish. So let's take a look at how many things that went on during this. Changes, you can see there are a lot of changes and conversations. So I'm just going to go to continue chat and what it is saying that new website is being monitored. These 2 websites, I wanted to test with my own website also, but I have removed it. The changes are now active. So what I can do, I can actually test this automation. I can just go here before publishing, I can do this. So what the agent did, agent 3 wires the trigger, API calls, parsing, an email. The key is reusable and scheduling parameterized inputs. No manual system is here. We can take a look at how we can publish this. So if we go to publish automation, it will come to this screen. So if I type in Monday 9 a.m., it will automatically generate the cron expression. And then I can select my city, Asia, Kuala Lumpur, and then it will be set here. Then I can publish this. But before publishing, let's go and do a testing how this works out. I am setting it to run every Monday at 9 a.m. in my time zone. You can shift this to match your reporting window or whenever you prefer to get the email. Now time for the test run. I'm going to do a manual test run from the workflow. We are going to inspect the logs, the API calls and strategies. In the playground, I'm going to click test automation to trigger this. So let's go. We can also see executed API calls. We are going to see how it comes out. It might take a few moments to complete. So the process has completed. You can see the green color window. means it has processed all these steps in the workflow. In the success log, we can see email sent is equal to true. So now we are going to see the real email, how it looks like. Here is our email. It says weekly website speed report, Monday, September 15th. The blog name or the URL, the mobile performance and the desktop performance, what is their state, values, same for another website, the mobile performance and desktop performance. This is automated report was generated by your website monitoring system. For better performance, consider optimizing images, enable compression and using a CDN. The email is done. The entire workflow is done roughly around 5 to 7 minutes of work. You have already seen how to publish it for regular usage. That means you can actually build up a lot of automation that requires repeated manual intervention. You can put it into automation, make your business efficient. So certain things you do not have to touch to get things done. So now this is being done. I have already done the Telegram bot. So let me show you the Telegram bot and how it works. It is pretty interesting and we're going to see how it comes out. Here is our Telegram bot that I have published. It is live and I'm going to show you the live how it works. So you can see that I have gone through a lot of problem, fixed the issues, like it had dependency issues and such things. All you have to do is ask what is the problem you are seeing on screen and the agent will fix it for you. So there is an architect behind the agent which can much more deeper problem solving for every component or every product you are building. Now it is published. You can see the green color icon and these are the app secrets. I need the OpenAI key and a Telegram bot. So the Telegram bot I get from Botfather to create a new bot, attach it to this system. And the OpenAI key is to train the AI to talk like Tony Stark. So let's take a look at how it works actually. We are going to open my Telegram and start chatting with the bot. So here is our bot. So let's ask about the signature item of Tony Stark. What is the best car he loves? So I'm going to type. Let's see what it comes out. So right now this application is live and it is talking with OpenAI. It is running GPT-5 when calling the API. So sometimes it takes a longer time because GPT-5 may be slower than older GPT models. But I wanted to test it with GPT-5 to see how intelligent it can be. Let us see how it comes out. Here we are. So let's see how the reply came out. The reply, if you look carefully and if you are very familiar with Tony Stark, you will know the talking style is exactly like him. Look, my best car already exists. It's red, gold and flies. But we're keeping tires on asphalt. The Stark space choice, I'd build it, layout, carbon tub, and he went in all this technical stuff. The description is very proper. V10 or e-tron modded, nostalgia play, basically a suit you sit in. It perfectly replicates the behavior of Tony Stark in the chat. Why this, he explained, etc, etc. So now I'm going to ask him a new question, whether this bot knows anything about me. But first, is a disclaimer, I haven't teach the bot anything. I will just ask, what do you think of? So I didn't give any kind of hints to the bot that who am I or what it is. So this is the whole point of using GPT-5 behind the scene to see how latest it has become. So let's see what is this reply comes out to. So let's see, this seems interesting. Right, short version, solid operator, low fluff, high utility. He sits in that Venn diagram of your product UX and growth and actually ships playbooks that you can use before launch. That's pretty detailed, comes with negative points as well. So this is the bot, this is the console output. So let's take a look at what are the files. It's actually not too much files. I'm going to show that at the end, you can see this is using GPT-5 for responses. This is something that is very interesting that you can build your bot. And this is just a primary idea what you can do. Why this matters? This is the gap Agent 3 closes. Continuous, reliable runs with low overhead. It scales from small checks like these or to larger weekly or daily tasks. Agent 3 by Replit brings autonomy for all. If you want practical automations like this, start here, replit.com/agent3. Here you go. You can get $10 credit when you purchase Replit Core through that link. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.